Welcome to class, everybody. And in the pursuit of our preparation for the IBC exams that will soon be coming up, we'll be looking at love and concern for others. The focus for today is on poverty. Today, we want to look at the causes of poverty. There's a need for us to understand these causes, to discuss on care for the poor, and to talk on the work of religious organizations. Now, the causes of poverty are very clear. Let me just outline a few that I want you to take note of. One cause of poverty is population. If the population of a nation is extremely very large, the nation may not have the necessary resources to be able to attend to its teeming population, especially if that nation is a little bit impoverished. Another cause of poverty is denial to basic health facilities. Another cause of poverty I want you to take note of is also corruption, especially in very many countries where resources meant to have been delegated for the benefit and welfare of the poor have been scooped away into private pockets by hungry and desperate politicians in power. Another cause of poverty that I want you to also take note of is conflict, war. We know war brings about destruction and a complete annihilation of structures and processes or resources that people may have depended upon for the course of their livelihoods. Now, when conflict does emerge, institutions, businesses, livelihoods are destroyed, and in some situations, even after the war is over, some individuals may not be able to recover again. So this is a serious cause of poverty in very many countries of the world. Another cause of poverty I want you to take note of also is natural disasters like typhoons, hurricanes, earthquakes, and this is common especially in Southeast Asia. And unfortunately, it does affect also the livelihoods of people, and it draws very many people who have been struggling to make a living. It drops them back again to the lowest rung in the ladder, in the nasty ladder called poverty. Now, when we consider the causes of poverty, there is a need also for us to look at the care for the poor. Now, Christianity compels upon us that we have a moral responsibility, irrespective of our means, to ensure that we show a hand of love and support towards those who are poor. This is very important, very necessary for people around us, not necessarily even those that are far. We have to start from even those that are around us. But there's a need for Christians, especially when they are blessed of the Lord, to consider a need to attend to the poor. And this is one of the reasons why Christians donate to religious organizations, charity organizations. Christians do their best to elevate the suffering of others, probably by contributing towards the free distribution of vaccines and medicines to those who are sick or those who are poor, especially in disaster-ravaged areas of the world. Now, when we look at the work of religious organizations, very many churches are trying in this direction, they're actually doing their best. But one church that is very notable in this regard is the Catholic Church. Now, they have an organization known as Caritas. We'll be dealing with this more when we get to aid agencies, but there's a need to also mention it here. Caritas attends to the poor in over 150 countries around the world. In fact, in any country where you have the presence of the Catholic Church, Caritas is also busy attending to the needs and welfare of the poor. And then notable again with the Catholic Church was the work of Mother Teresa in India. In fact, in 1979, she received the Nobel Peace Prize for her contributions towards the alleviation of poverty in India. She set up an organization that was permitted and acknowledged by the Catholic Church, and this organization actually attended to people who were extremely poor in Indian society, and especially those who were dying out in the streets. She will actually bring them in and then take care of them, and those who would survive will continue to go on in life. But those who died, she ensured that they died honorably instead of dying out like animals in the streets. So I want you to read the attachments I've sent to you on Google Classroom. I'm convinced you will have a lot of details in that direction. I've also given you some links I want you to take very seriously. I'm convinced that after you are through with the process of studying, I think you should be able to do justice to the class tax that has been attached to this activity. May the Lord bless you. Thank you very much.